the great man.
महान है वह हमेशा के लिए अब आमीन और आमीन।
Some company. Very nice. Very nice indeed.
Nana Rokuda Hadiko Kukai Kukai Kulahi for Kamus.
Yes, my friend. Grant, O Lord, as thou hast cast my lot in a fair ground, that I may show forth contentment by rejoicing in the privileges with which thou hast strewn my path, and by using to the full my opportunities for service. In hours of hardship, preserve me from self-pity and endow me with the warrior's mind, that even in the heat of battle, I may be inspired with a sense of vocation and win the peace of the victor through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. God, who has sent us to school in this strange life of ours, and has set us tasks which test all our courage, trust, and fidelity, may we not spend our days complaining at circumstance or fretting at discipline, but give ourselves to learn of life and to profit by every experience. Make us strong to endure. We pray that when trials come upon us, we may not shirk the issue or lose our faith in thy goodness, but committing our souls unto thee, who knowest the way that we take, come forth as gold tried in the fire. Grant by thy grace that we may not be found wanting in the hour of crisis. When the battle is set, may we know on which side we ought to be. And when the day goes hard, cowards steal from the field, and heroes fall around the standard. May our place be found where the fight is fiercest. If we faint, may we not be faithless. If we fall, may it be while facing the foe. Amen.
Give us, O Lord, a mind after thine own heart, that we may delight to do thy will, O our God. And let thy law be written on our hearts. Give us courage and resolution to do our duty, and a heart to be spent in thy service, and in doing all the good that possibly we can for the few remaining days of our pilgrimage here on earth. Grant this, we humbly beseech thee, for the sake of Jesus Christ, thy Son, our Lord. Amen.
we be ever courteous and easy to be entreated. Never let me fall into a peevish or contentious spirit, but follow peace with all men, offering forgiveness, inviting them by courtesies, ready to confess my own errors, apt to make amends, and desirous to be reconciled. Let no sickness or cross accident, no employment or weariness make me angry or ungentle, and discontented or unthankful or uneasy. Give me the spirit of a Christian, charitable, humble, merciful and meek, useful and liberal, complying with every chance, angry at nothing but my own sins, and grieving at the sins of others, that while my passion obeys my reason, and my reason is religious, and my religion is pure and undefiled, managed with humility and adorned with charity, I may dwell in thy love and be thy son and servant forever, through Jesus Christ our Lord. O, thou loving and tender Father in heaven, we confess before thee in sorrow how hard and unsympathetic are our hearts, how often we have sinned against our neighbors by want of compassion and tenderness, how often we have felt no true pity for their trials and sorrows, and have neglected to comfort, help, and visit them. O Father, forgive this our sin, and lay it not to our charge. Give us grace ever to alleviate the crosses and difficulties of those around us, and never to add to them. Teach us to be consolers in sorrow, to take thought for the stranger, the widow, and the orphan. Let our charity show itself not in words only, but in deed. In truth, teach us to judge as thou dost, with forbearance, with much pity and indulgence, and help us to avoid all unloving judgment of others. For the sake of Jesus Christ, thy Son, who loved us and gave himself for us. Amen.